Each year, cash-strapped Louisiana doles out millions of dollars in overtime to state employees.
And some new numbers obtained by the I-Team have state lawmakers now asking a lot of questions.
WDSU I-Team investigative reporter Travis Mackle has the details on just who's getting paid and how much they're making.
Each day, tens of thousands of drivers cross the Greater New Orleans Bridge, which is policed by Crescent City Connection cops. The officers patrol the bridge and its on-ramps 24/7. And public records show many of the officers are working extra hours, in some cases making tens of thousands of dollars extra in overtime. Last year, two officers both made a base salary of $50,000 and collected an additional $22,000 each in overtime. Two other officers in upper management each made base salaries of $58,000 and collected $19,000 more in overtime. The Louisiana Department of Transportation and Development oversees the Crescent City Connection Police Department, and records show that state agency is paying out lots of overtime.
Overtime has historically been something that's abused.
And while no one's been accused of doing anything wrong, some people in DOTD are making more in overtime than their base salaries. Records show a highway foreman named Joseph LeBlanc was paid more than $65,000 in overtime in 2010. His base salary, $54,700. And an engineer technician named Terrell Reinhardt made more than $33,000 in overtime, his salary, $35,000 a year. All of the financial figures were put together by the New Orleans-based think tank, the Pelican Institute. They put all state salaries and overtime on a public website called LouisianaSunshine.org.
This information is public for a reason. I mean, we've made a policy decision that we should have access to this kind of information.
And some lawmakers say the amount of overtime being paid out is jarring, especially in a state trying to fill a $1.6 billion budget deficit.
When you're making more than your salary in overtime, I think we have to look at how the work is being distributed in your office. And we don't want to micromanage each department, but if you're telling me that somebody makes $55,000 annual salary and their overtime is $65,000 a year, that's a pretty significant jump.
Many want to know how it's happening.
There's only a certain amount of time in a day that someone has to work.
Another state department paying out plenty of overtime, wildlife and fisheries. The website shows the highest paid person in the department is Michael Carlos. His base salary is just over $100,000 a year, but he made $55,000 in overtime last year, meaning he made more than Robert Barham, the head of the agency appointed by the governor. A biologist program manager named Daniel Baker made a base salary of $63,000 and was paid $59,000 in overtime, and a supervisor named Mark Castile made $49,000 in overtime while his base pay was $55,000. And almost every enforcement officer listed made significant overtime, sometimes more than $25,000 a year.
Oh, it absolutely raises red flags. And again, I mean, we need to know more about the circumstances when you're looking at individual employees.
A spokesperson for Wildlife and Fisheries says in 2008, 2009, and 2010, officers and employees worked significant overtime due to Hurricanes Gustav, Ike, and the Gulf oil spill. That spokesperson says almost all overtime does not come from the state, but from federal grants, reimbursements, and in the case of the oil spill, BP. Kane's website lays out all state agencies, and he hopes making this type of information public pays off.
Well, I sure hope they have some answer.
And Scott and Norman, late tonight, the Louisiana Department of Transportation and Development sent us a statement which says in the last year, they have proactively initiated reforms when it comes to overtime inside that department. Reporting in the newsroom, I'm Travers Mackle, WDSU.